Well, in a general sense, what an outlier is, it's a data point that's either like a lot larger than all the other data points or a lot smaller than all the other data points. But we're going to be more specific in this video using the inner quartile range, the third quartile, the first quartile, and I'm going to show you how to find precisely which data points are outliers. So the first thing we need to do is create a box and whiskers plot. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing we want to do is you want to take your data points, order them from lowest to highest. Okay, that's important. The next thing you want to do is you want to find out where the median is. So the median is the middle number. And what you want to do is you want to count towards the middle. So we've got 1 and 1, 2 and 2, 3 and 3, 4 and 4, 5 and 5. Now notice there's two that are in the middle. So when there's a tie like that, what you do is you add those two numbers together and you divide by 2. So here you can see this is coming out to, let's see, what is that? 178 divided by 2, which comes out to 89. So it's basically the number that's halfway in between 88 and 90. So that means that our median, I'll just say median, MED, is 89, and that's going to be right here. So then what you do is you take the upper half of the data and you find the middle number. So you don't want to count the median, but just to the right of that. So we have 1 and 1, 2 and 2. You can see 92 right here is going to be the middle of the upper half of the data. We call this our upper quartile, or you can call this quartile 3. Now, same thing with the lower half of the data. Again, you don't want to count the median, just to the below or to the left. 1 and 1, 2 and 2. You can see 82 is the middle one. That's our lower quartile. I'll just write LQ, and this is also called the first quartile, or Q1. So what we're going to do now is we're going to arrange our data on a number line. So I'm just going to make a number line like so, and I'm just going to start over here at like 50, and then 60. I'm just going to count by 10, 70, 80, 90, 100. Okay, so 89 would be approximately right here, because I'm going to draw a line. Then we've got 92, which is going to be right about here. I'm just estimating 92. And then we've got 82, which is right about here. Okay, so that forms our box. Okay, so this is Q3 here. This is Q1 here. This is our median here in the middle. And then we've got our whiskers. So 60 is our minimum. Okay, that's our low value, our lowest value. And then we have our maximum, which is 97. So 97, just a little shy of 100. It's going to be like that. So what we want to do is we want to identify the inner quartile range. So that's going to be Q3 minus Q1. So in this case, it's 92 minus 82. So our interquartile range, our upper quartile minus our lower quartile, comes out to 10. We want to then take 1.5 times that inner quartile range. 1.5 times 10 is 15. Okay, so then what you want to do is you want to take that number, 15, and you want to add it to the third quartile. So in this case, this is 92. If we take 92 plus 15, that gives us 107. Are there any data points that are greater than 107? No. So that means there's not going to be any outliers, you know, above the data set here. Then if we take our Q1, so Q1 minus 1.5, the inner quartile range. So in this case, Q1 is 82 minus our inner quartile range times 1.5, which is 15. That comes out to 67. So what we have to do is we have to ask ourselves, are there any data points that are lower or further to the left than 67? And here you can see that 60 is lower. So we have at least one data point here that's considered an outlier according to this definition. So here would be our outlier of 60. Again, we didn't have any that were above the data set. We had some that were below the data set. But the key is find the inner quartile range, multiply by 1.5, add it to the upper quartile. If there's any numbers greater, those are going to be outliers. Take the lower quartile, subtract 1.5 times the inner quartile range. If there's any data points that are lower, those will also be outliers. So great job. If you're new to the channel, hit the circle subscribe button below. I look forward to helping you in the future videos, and I'll talk to you soon.